Alright, welcome back. This video is created in response to the request from Suman Kumar to create a website using CoinMarketCap widgets. So let's get started. Before we begin, I just want to mention that you don't have to call me sir. You can just call me Karthik and that should be fine. Again, I'm just a random guy on the internet, so you don't have to call me sir. You can just call me by my name. Okay, that should be fine. All right, so this is the website where you can create your, customize your widget, so to speak. So you must already be familiar with this. If not, I'll run you through all the options. So this is how the widget would look like when you embed this on your page. So the way this would work is you have to customize all these options here and you would get a real-time view of how the widget would look like on this section. And this is the code for these options, okay? So let's try to change it for a minute. Okay, so let's try to add different settings. So I'll select Ethereum. Yeah, I'll select Ethereum and you can see that it immediately changed to Ethereum and the rank is 2. So if you don't want to show the rank on your widget, you can deselect this option and it automatically disappears. And yeah, so you can play around with these settings, but this is how the final page would look like. And I'll show you how you can embed this on your own website, okay? All right, I'm using brackets as my text editor, but you can do it anywhere. Let me create an empty HTML file. I'll call it index.html, okay? And then I'll just initialize my HTML page. That's it. And I need a head tag. Again, so there are easier alternatives available in the market for free, but this is how I do it and this is what I'm used to it, okay? So I'm just initializing my all the different tags. And I'll just need a script tag. So it's going to be really straightforward. All you have to do is just copy this code and paste it on your website. So this is my web page, right? So I can just paste it here. And if you observe closely, there are two tags. So I should not do it in the script tag, sorry. I have to do it inside the body tag or header tag. Okay. So if you observe closely, there are two tags. One is a script tag and the other one is a div tag. Okay. So let me separate these out so that you see clearly. Okay, so this is script tag and the other one is div tag. The script tag is common for any ticker that you add. So you don't have to copy this every single time. So what you can do is you can just cut it and paste it in the header section so that you only have to copy this div tag whenever you want to add a new widget on your website. Okay, so that's it. It's that simple. So I'll just open this page on the browser and show you how it would look like. Okay. Okay. So I have the page open in my browser and you can see this is how the ticker would look like. It's actually quite similar, but you can see that it's quite stretched out and it doesn't have the same dimensions, the same, width and height as shown here. So you can customize the settings. I'll show you in a minute how to do that. So typically what I use to customize the layout is Bootstrap 4, or you can use the materialized design. So in this video, I'll show you how you can use Bootstrap 4 and quite easily you can customize the layout and you can add several widgets on the same page. So let me do that. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is add all the Bootstrap related CDNs. CDN is nothing but a JavaScript library that is built specifically for a particular module. So Bootstrap is a module. If you're not familiar with what Bootstrap is, it's nothing but a module that allows you to customize front end layout. Okay. So I'm going to use Bootstrap to show you how we can customize the layout. So all you have to do is include these libraries first, as I did on the top, and then you can create rows and columns using simple div tags. So I'll show you how to do that. So first I'll just create a div tag. Okay. And the first tag should be container, okay, and inside that create another div tag and I'll call it row, class is equal to row. So the way Bootstrap works is we specify these different classes and the libraries that we specified here would take care of all the layout design internally. So all we have to do is just pass the appropriate class and appropriate tags and everything else is taken care by these CDNs or these libraries that we added. Okay, so by default we create a container and then inside that we create a row and inside that let's add these tickers. Okay, so this is a row, right? You must be familiar with what rows and columns are, right? If you're familiar with a table structure, you have different rows and you have different columns. So I want to create, let's say, I have a 1920 by 1080p resolution monitor. So let me try to add like five tickers in one row. Okay, so let me just copy this and paste it five times. Okay, and let me refresh this. Okay, it's not fitting it. So maybe I'll just try to add four. Yeah. Oh, sorry, I'll just have to delete this. Yeah. Refresh. That's it. So these are added. And you can change these indicators. So for example, all you see is Ethereum, right? If I want to add something else, I can just select Bitcoin. Okay, and I'll select this. And I just have to copy the div class, not the script tag. Okay, I'll just replace it with this one and let me refresh the page. Now you'll see Bitcoin on the right hand side. So you can add any tickers that you want over here, and they will show up on your web page. So one thing to keep in mind is that these are not refreshed automatically. So you have to reload the page every few seconds in order to have the recent or, you know, the most updated values. And to do that, it's quite simple. We can do that in just one line of code. So let's try to do it. In the script tag, I'm going to create something called setInterval. And setInterval, we can pass a function that runs every few seconds. Okay, so I'm going to pass an anonymous function. Okay, and inside the function, I'll say location.reload. Yes, and it takes in another parameter, which is the frequency. And this is specified in milliseconds. Okay, so I want to refresh the page every, let's say, 15 seconds. Okay, so I'll say 15 times. Each second is 1000 milliseconds, right? So I just put in 1000. So what this line of code means is that it executes this function every 15 seconds. Okay, and inside this function, we are reloading the page. So what it means is every 15 seconds, the page gets reloaded. Okay, so I'll just change it to 3 seconds to demonstrate how this works. Let me refresh the page. And you should notice that after 3 seconds, it should get reloaded automatically. Yeah, it just happened. So yeah, depending on your requirement, you can just put in appropriate, you know, refresh timer, and you can add different rows and columns in this way. So let me try to add another row. So this is one row, right? I can add another row by just copying and pasting here. And now you should see two rows of data. You see, it's that simple. All right, one last thing that I want to explain is that this code would work only when you don't have Adblock Plus extension installed on your browser. But I want to walk you through some steps that you have to do if you have Adblock Plus installed. Okay, let me turn on Adblock Plus and come right back and show you what happens when you have that extension installed. Okay. All right. Adblock Plus is turned back on. And now when I refresh the page, you would see that these tickers would not appear. So let me refresh. You can see that nothing comes up. And if I click on F12, which is the debugger console, you can see that these are blocked by the client. So what's happening is Adblock Plus is treating these tickers as some spam or as some ad, and it's trying to block these requests. So we have to find a way to exclude or filter out these URLs from Adblock Plus. And I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay, so these are the three URLs that you have to include in your exception filter in Adblock Plus for the ticker to work. Now you might wonder, how did I come up with these URLs? How do I know that these are the ones that we have to enable? So it's simple. So what I do is I just refresh the page, and whenever I see some URL here, I just try to filter it out. It's that simple. So let me try to do it manually so that you would understand how I came up with this. And if you don't really care about this, I'll leave all these three URLs in the description box so that you can access it directly. Okay. So first, when I refresh the page, I see this URL. So I just copy this, and let me try to zoom in so that you can see the URL clearly. Yeah. You can see the URL now, right? I'll just copy this URL, and go to ABP, left click on it, and then go to settings, and then go to advanced, and on the bottom you see my filter list. So click on start creating my filter list, and here the way to specify is @@. I don't know, it's just the convention. I just read some documentation. You have to include 2 @ before starting the URL. Okay, so that is my first filter. I'm going to save it, and let me refresh the page. Click on refresh. Okay, so we got some new URLs, right? So we have to exclude these. Let me just copy these first one. You can see that all these 4 URLs are the same, but you see 4 errors because we have added 4 tickers on the page. Okay, so I'm just going to this one and edit the filter, and again @@, place the URL. Now you can see that it looks like an REST API call, right? You can see that the reference is widget and convert is USD and the ticker is 1027 something. So you can see that there are like thousands of coins on CoinMarketCap. Now you should not paste this entire URL, and instead you have to filter from here. So the reason I truncated the URL is because the URL contains several filters. So if we include the full URL and if we try to add another widget, that would fail because the URL would be different for that ticker, right? So when we truncate it to here, it includes all the URLs, you know, all the filters or all the parameters that fall under widgets.coinmarketcap.com. I hope it is clear. Let me save it. Let me refresh the page. Okay, now we can see the tickers, but the image is not showing up, right? So that's because there is another URL that we have to enable. Let me zoom out a little bit. Yeah. Okay, so let me copy this and go to the filters, edit filter, and hit @@, paste it. Same thing here. So we have to remove a portion of the URL. I'll do it up to here. And click on save. Yeah, and refresh the page. Awesome, so we don't see any errors now. I'll close the page and it works. So even if you have Adblock Plus installed, all you have to do is just paste these 3 URLs in your filter list and this should work automatically for you. And you know, in order to have the latest data, you have to reload the page every few seconds. That's it for this video. I hope you found this informative. And if you have any requests or, you know, any questions, just leave them in the comment section. And if you want to send any video requests, you can send them to me at my email address that is about to pop up on the screen. All right. Have a good one. Talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.